Let's take a look at a few of these optimizations and how they combine to take AI to a whole new level for developers.
Great. Here, we're showing how easy it is to use the Intel Neural Compressor, which is an open source Python library to help developers quickly deploy low precision inference solutions on popular deep learning frameworks such as TensorFlow. Out of the box, developers can run AI on Intel CPUs literally in minutes using a simple GUI as opposed to our competitor solutions where developers spend time manually writing and optimizing code. In fact, developers spend time using ink can increase their productivity by up to 18x versus TensorRT when quantizing models from FP32 to Int8 numerical formats.
So how do these optimizations actually impact performance, John?
Here we're looking at the deep learning workload, SSD ResNet 34, a popular object detection topology running on our third gen Intel Xeon scalable processors. And it's running stock TensorFlow. You can see that the baseline inference throughput here is about 13 images per second. As Greg noted earlier, TensorFlow now has native one API deep neural network library optimizations, which lead to about a 1.5x speedup over our baseline. Next, Ink, which automatically prunes and quantizes trained models from FP32 to Int8, takes advantage of Intel DL Boost on our third gen Xeon scalable processors to deliver an additional 3.9x speedup.
So these performance improvements are great, and I want to see what we can do on Sapphire Rapids with AMX instructions.
Great, let's run those numbers now. As you can see, with Sapphire Rapids, we're getting an additional 4.8x speedup with AMX.
Okay, so then that's a total of 30 times total AI performance gain in one generation with these hardware and software optimizations. Do I have that right?
That's right. And to put our pre-production CPU performance into further perspective, we also benchmarked Sapphire Rapids versus GPU on ResNet 50, which is the popular image recognition topology. As you can see, our dual socket server with the next gen general purpose CPU can infer over 24,000 images per second compared to 16,000 images per second with the NVIDIA A30 GPU. This means we can deliver better than 1.5x the performance of NVIDIA's mainstream inferencing GPU for 2022. And don't forget that the A30 GPU still needs a host CPU to function.
Well, the bottom line is that today, so many customers are able to deliver the AI performance they need inside the applications they're running on Xeon processors, thanks to the built-in AI acceleration and extensive software optimizations. And with Sapphire Rapids coming soon, and with more AI, it'll be possible for us to do even more and really not need the expensive proprietary power-consuming discrete accelerators that are in the market today.